In a recent development, the Delhi High Court delivered a significant ruling on a plea filed by Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal seeking relief from the Enforcement Directorate's coercive actions in connection with the money laundering probe. The bench, headed by Justices Suresh Kumar Kett and Manoj Jain, made a decisive decision, refusing to grant interim relief to Kejriwal at this stage. Kejriwal's plea came to response to the ninth summons issued by the ED urging him to appear before them, which he had consistently refused, denouncing the summons as illegal. Addressing reports, Additional Solicitor General S.B. Raju emphasized that the petition was deemed not maintainable, characterizing it as a desperate attempt.
The petition is not maintainable. That was our main ground. And according to us, it's not maintainable. It's a desperate attempt for him to file the petition.
The Delhi HC echoed the statement, declining to provide interim relief. The case revolves around alleged corruption and money laundering concerning the formulation and execution of Delhi's excise policy for 2021-22, subsequently annulled. Notably, AAP leaders Manish Sisodia and Sanjay Singh find themselves in judicial custody amidst this investigation. Meanwhile, a political confrontation ensued between the BJP and AAP over the ED summons to Kejriwal. BJP's Nalin Kohli highlighted the irony of Kejriwal's situation, pointing out his political origins in anti-corruption activism. Kohli questioned why Kejriwal, who once vowed to combat corruption, is now evading scrutiny.
What an irony that Mr. Arvind Kejriwal, who began his entire political career on the principle that he would fight against corruption, he would not let corruption happen, is today himself running away from an investigation into a corruption scam. He is the Chief Minister of Delhi. Under his leadership and on his directions, his ministers function. Two of his ministers are in jail without bail for an investigation into the liquor scam, the excise scam of Delhi. And Mr. Kejriwal has chosen to ignore or run away from 8 summons so far. On some excuse or the other, I am busy with electioneering, I am in Vipassana, these summons cannot be sent to me. Today he's running to the court, trying to set conditions. The court will decide what the court has to do. Anyone can go before the court. But the larger question is, what is Mr. Kejriwal so scared of that he's running away from joining the investigation? What is it that he knows that will come out and send a clear message to the people that something wrong has happened in Delhi?
As the political and legal saga unfolds, the question lingers: what lies behind Kejriwal's reluctance to join the investigation?